Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Bestenslot here, back with my beloved Red Brush, and tonight we're going to take a look at a few different models and toys and stuff coming out next year for Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, and indeed the original Jurassic Park. Now, initially, what we're going to be looking at in this video is the revealing of the 2019 Mattel toy line for Jurassic World as a franchise. And there's a ton of really cool stuff in here if you're into the more figurine, toy, playing aspect of the franchise, which I know a lot of you are, or some of my younger viewers, or if you've got kids. Or hell, if you're 35 and you like smashing your dinosaurs together and pretending they're killing each other, who am I to judge? So I've got some images here, all courtesy of JurassicOutpost.com. But then there's a few other things I want to show you towards the end, which I think are really, really cool, including a potential future Mattel toy, which, whilst it's not confirmed yet, is very, very cool as well, and would be one of the few toys I would consider buying personally. I'm just going to flash through a few of these just to show them to people. And this first thing is called the Attack Pack Assortment. Very, very obvious what it is. It's basically just little toys that you can model. They don't attack or bite or anything particularly, but they've got like hinges. You can see here on the Velociraptor, it's got a hinge at the jaw, so you can open the jaw, you can move the legs, you can see you can move the arms. Just little well-made nice figurines, basically, if you want to add to your collection. I've got to say, Mattel's stuff is a huge jump. I can't remember who handled Jurassic World, but I think it was Hasbro, I don't know. But Mattel are doing so much more work than they ever did. You know, we've got constant new releases, really cool colouring. I mean, that Protoceratops, what I assume is a Protoceratops, I didn't get the official name for it. The colouring is awesome, same with the Rampurancus, same with the Velociraptor. These two on the right-hand side, I don't know what this is. I don't know if it's meant to be an Herrerasaurus. I also think this may be the Silurus, but I'm not 100% sure on that, so don't quote me on that. That is just a guess on my part. Moving on, we have the Savage... Sorry, the image isn't quite as good. The Savage Striker Assortment. This is a slightly more complex version of the same thing, in that basically they do have proper sort of attack animations or different things that they do. The Tapiara will flap its rings. Wings? Blue will bite. Stegomorlock... like has obviously something to do with the head, sort of little head bump or something like that. Strachosaurus, again, I don't know what this is. There's no names for a lot of these. I'm kind of having to just guess and sort of figure it out, and that one's kind of thrown me a little bit. Not really sure. I'd love some suggestions. If any of you at home think you can guess what these are or think I've got any of them wrong, feel free to let me know. Moving on. Don't want to spend too much on these. These aren't the exciting ones. Next up, we have, I can't remember what this is called. I think it's like the attack damage ones. And we've got a Pteranodon and a Plesiosaurus, and a few more that haven't been revealed quite yet. Same thing again though, the colour scheme on that Pteranodon is absolutely baller. I don't particularly like these as toys, these weird kind of like, the idea is, you know, it shows where they've been bitten or something like that. You could have one dinosaur attack your Plesiosaurus, and then, oh no, there's a chunk has fallen out. But it looks very unnatural to me, so these aren't really things I would ever consider personally, but I can see why some people like them. And I really like that this Fallen Kingdom line, or this Jurassic World treatment of the franchise in general, they've really expanded out into creatures that clearly have never had a place in the franchise before. Plesiosaurus, Styracosaurus, Dimetrodon was there in Fallen Kingdom briefly, but only, you know, a stuffed one. Tapiara, stuff like that. These aren't creatures and dinosaurs that have ever been really properly in the franchise, but they're all making it into the toy line, which I think is just a really cool thing. I'd still like to see, I know we've got the Mosasaurus, and I know it's a big part of the franchise, but since we have the Mosasaurus and we've gone into the seas, and there were hints of a Plesiosaurus in Jurassic World that there was going to be one before release, a lot of us thought it might actually make it into the film. Maybe, just maybe, we can get this guy in. I think this design here, this would suit Jurassic World down to an absolute T. Be very, very cool. Next up, we have a Tracker ATV set with a Dracorax. It's got a gripper thing on the front, which is science somehow, and Owen Grady, and he'll go around and grip some dinosaurs. That's about all I have to say on that one. We have the Mega Jewel Attack Assortment. These are all getting bigger and more expensive as we go along. We've got a Stegosaurus and a Suchomimus right there pictured, and these are basically dinosaurs with double attacks. So this one can probably bite and whip the tail, this probably whips the tail and shakes its head around. And there's a button somewhere, I can't quite see it, maybe it's this little seam here in the leg, where you can press one to do one attack, you can press one to do another attack, or you can press both at the same time to make your dinosaur whip its head back and forth and go absolutely bloody mental. The one thing I like about this, we've got Stegosaurus and Suchomimus, both Stegosaurus established part of the franchise, and Suchomimus has popped up in a lot of games and was, you know, meant to be in Jurassic World as well. A Margosaurus, however, is listed on the details for this pack. Now, we didn't get a picture of it, but a Margosaurus is one of my favourite dinosaurs. A Margosaurus is absolutely awesome. I think I spelt it wrong there. A Margosaurus, for those who don't know, is a big-ass spiky sauropod, basically. A Margosaurus is very cool. And I think a Mega Jewel Attack Assortment, it's a mouthful, would be a very cool version of it. I can imagine this massive Amargasaurus whipping its tail back and forth. So hopefully we'll get a good look at that very soon. Last one of this set before we get onto what I would consider the more exciting stuff is the Bite and Fight T-Rex, which, like the things we just had, is another dual attack thing. You can see here the tail is bent very unnaturally because there's a button there. So you hit that button, the tail goes pow. You know what? Let's do some science. One sec, folks. So you hit the button and there you go. Just in case you were curious. And obviously the mouth itself can bite down. So you could bite and whip at the same time. It's basically the same thing as these ones right here, but scaled up a little bit. Now, we're going to look at something else. This is concept art for potential future Mattel work. We've got two of these. This is the first one. This is not the exciting one, although this is pretty cool. This is the turned over explorer from the first film that obviously showed up again in Fallen Kingdom. At least we believe it's the same one, like everyone's just assuming it's the same one. There's a wheels launch with button activation. God knows why the wheels would launch in any situation, but they do. The wheel collapses as Blue defends her nest, which is pretty cool. You can get a little human figurine, not included, I think that's meant to say, but he gets trapped in a little ribcage here. This is okay. This one, however, is awesome. This is concept art again for like a potential future sort of play set for Mattel, and I really like this. This is very, very cool. Obviously, this is Dennis Nedry with his Dilophosaurus, the Jeep stuck at the top of the ridge. Even the little barbell can right there, not quite in the right place, and this should be dirtier and stuff like that, but it's just got all these like individual little pieces. If they release anything like this that, you know, has all these parts, it's got the Dilophosaurus, it's got Dennis Nedry in his raincoat, it's got the winch, it's got the, you know, the docks sign, it's got the water sort of muddy bank, it's got the Jeep, it's got the barbell can, I would buy this in an instant. This is very, even if it's a toy, I don't get like a proper little articulated, that's the word I've been looking for the last 6 minutes, articulated toy, I don't care, I would buy it because this looks awesome. And I'd like to see more of this kind of thing. I accept that it's really cool for the kids and stuff in particular, you know, to get all these different varied dinosaurs. And I love that. I love that they're doing that because it's going to educate people about dinosaurs they may never have heard of before. How many five-year-olds have heard of Amargasaurus, for example? Or Archaeonophimimus, as the film would like to say. But, also, what's wrong with Claire's pronunciation of Archaeonophimimus? It seems fine to me. Whatever. But stuff like this, like proper homages to the original film, a lot of these would be appreciated. Speaking of homages to the original film, I have three more things to show you in total. The first is from Chronicle Collectibles. It is the Rotunda Rex. It is $1,349 and it is absolutely goddamn massive. This thing is humongous, ladies and gentlemen. It's very cool. It's obviously the Rex in the Rotunda at the end of the film. I'll get some new shots up here. You see there what it's standing on, like the collapsed skulls and stuff. It is 1:9 scale, making it 24 inches tall, 22 inches in diameter. This thing is absolutely ginormous. I believe it is the second biggest accurate T-Rex representation of Jurassic Park in the world. The biggest one being another one that these Chronicle Collectibles make themselves, which is 1:5 scale. But 1:9, this is 1/9 the size of a T-Rex. I know that's obvious, but if you just try to wrap your head around that, that's a really, 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 really big model. And they did show a, I don't have the actual picture, they did show a barbell can next to it, like a shaving foam can, which is, you know, a decent sized little thing, and it came up to like there. So this thing is humongous. This is the kind of thing that if I was loaded, I would like to buy, but I would also realize that in my current living situation, it would not fit anywhere. This is like a fifth of my bedroom right now, but it is very, very cool. The scratches, the roar, this kind of gravity defying when dinosaurs rule the earth banner. I really like it. It's very, very cool. Is it as cool as half naked Ian Malcolm though? That is another question. Much cheaper, less than half the price at $599. Probably available on some, not pay-as-you-go, that would make any sense, but a pay-over-time sort of deal. Yeah, there's Ian Malcolm with his luscious locks and stuff. I've got to say, bring up a big picture here, I don't know if the face has quite been nailed enough. It's missing that inherent angry, sarcastic snarkiness behind it. It definitely is recognisable as Ian Malcolm. You know, it's got the open shirt and stuff, of course it is. It's in the exact pose, it's very, very, very well detailed. It's definitely Ian Malcolm, but I think the face is just missing something, you know? Just a little, like a little furrow in the brow, maybe, just to make it seem a little bit more Ian Malcolm-esque. I think it could be improved, but it's still very cool. And I know a lot of you have wanted to own a half-naked Ian Malcolm, because who hasn't, frankly? Who hasn't? Nerds. That's who. The last thing we're going to look at is from Iron Studios. And this may be my favourite, and not just because it's the cheapest, but this may be my favourite thing in the entire collection tonight. There it is. Now, this was shown a few days ago, or a while ago, now like a couple of weeks it's gone out, but I just wanted to do a general update of all the stuff that is out now or coming out soon. So this is from Iron Studios. Iron as in Iron. I'll draw the word iron just in case. Iron. $399 for this little diorama. I can't remember the scale. I think it's 1 to 9, something like that. 1 to 12, 1 to 7, 1 to 8. It's 1 to something, I'll tell you that much. And it is, of course, a recreation of the kitchen scene from the first film. Tim's face is a little bit odd, but the detail in his thing is just absolutely awesome. I've got a few more pictures. Look at that. The tongue sticking out as it goes for the ladle that he knocked off. There's the picture of the one on top. So you can see how I love this thing. I think it's very cool, but I've done the wrong thing. Oopsie daisy. One sec, folks. One sec. This is important. This was, oh, for God's sake. This is for science. I'm a very professional YouTuber. Go with me. Dum, dum, dum. What's going on? All right, let me try one more time. There we go. Got there eventually. That might be a bit big. Tim's face is strange. It's about the nicest way I can say it. It's a little bit, faces are difficult to get, like accurate, properly accurate faces is a difficult thing. But he looks spooked, right? It looks like Tim. The Raptors itself looks absolutely awesome. The kitchen set looks really, really cool. You know, all these little things hanging off the ladles and the spatulas and stuff like that. It's honestly just a very, very cool recreation of that scene. And it's a lot smaller than the other pieces. It's more reasonably priced. You could pay for it over time. If I was going to buy anything from this whole set, this would definitely take the biscuit, as they would say. I think this is really, really cool. Hopefully this is available for a long time. Hopefully my parents and extended family, if I poke them, will give it me for Christmas. I'll have to have a go. But yeah, this is awesome. And that's about it. That's all I've got to show you. So if you're into the toy stuff, there's a lot from Mattel to look forward to next year. There's a ton of stuff still coming that I haven't managed to show you guys. Like there's a giant, kind of like we've had the colossal T-Rex, apparently there might be a colossal Brachiosaurus on the way as well, which would be very, very cool. The colossal T-Rex, if you did miss that, that's getting re-released. It was very popular, so they're going to bring that back out again. And just a bunch more stuff in general, like the Amargosaurus that I couldn't quite show you tonight. And of course, we've got the concept art stuff. So again, that might land in the future. That's not made it to model yet, but it's definitely an idea they're floating. And then we got these really cool Ian Malcolm and T-Rex and Raptor Kitchen things. Lots of good stuff. And a nice easy video for me, as per usual. Okay, we're going to end it there. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know in the comments down below, do you like any of these? Are you considering buying any of these, you know? Or is there anything you'd still like to see? Personally, what I would like to see is a diorama of this quality that matches this scene. Something like this, but like this, would be. I would buy that. I would literally find a way to save them. Actually, not right now because I'm dirt poor. But in general, I would find a way to get the money and buy it. Because this, for me, is my favourite scene in the original Jurassic Park, I would say, now that I think about that out loud. First time I've ever said that, I think. I think this is my favourite scene in Jurassic Park. And I don't think it's ever been done justice, particularly. Because the Dilophosaurus, at the end of the day, is not a big part of the franchise. The Dilophosaurus is in literally one scene in the entire franchise other than in hologram form, which considering how tied Jurassic Park and Dilophosaurus is quite surprising when you think about it, how briefly it's actually been in the films. Anyways, but this scene recreated like this, I would kill for that. I think that would be very, very cool. Even with, like, make it a little fountain, get some running water going. Either way, I'd love that. But let me know what you think. What could they make to entice you in to spend a little bit of money on some cool Jurassic Park stuff? I will see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. A little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.